Let's go to US lawyer Benjamin Chu to sort of find out where this could end. Benjamin, we'll bring you in. What will this actually mean as far as sentencing? First of all, when do they start hearing sentencing submissions?
Well, the sentencing is not determined by the jury. It will be determined by Judge Merchan, and he has a lot of discretion and a lot of options. It can range anywhere from fines to imprisonment. And it's possible that the former president will rue the day that he took so many shots at the judge and the judge's daughter, which is a very unusual tack for a criminal defendant to take.
So Donald Trump, now a convicted felon, can he run for president?
Legally, he can run for president. There is no prohibition for doing that. In fact, we have precedent. The socialist candidate Eugene V. Debs not only ran for president as a convicted felon, but he was actually in, I believe he was in jail at the time he was running for office.
And what happened?
He lost.
Yeah.
But he was not a major party candidate.
So, but haven't Trump's polls been going up as he stood there outside the court every day and said, this guy's a turkey, amongst other things. It's all a conspiracy to get me. Donald Trump is winning in the polls, isn't he? Do you think this will change this?
Yes, I do. I mean, I'm a lawyer. I'm not a politician, but the polls have consistently said that there are anywhere between 7% and 10% of Americans who would not vote for a convicted felon. So the small middle that will determine the election in November does care about the outcome of this case and the other cases that are pending. This is probably the only one that will have gone to a verdict, but there's no poll in which the former president is ahead by more than that 7%. So I do think that though these verdicts won't change the views of his true believers and core supporters, it's going to affect that small middle who will decide the election.
So, Benjamin, these 34 counts labeled white collar crime at varying levels, will he go to jail, do you think?
You know, this judge has been so fair, you know, despite the defamatory attacks that have been labeled against him personally and his daughter. I think he will be extremely fair. My guess would be, to the extent that there is any incarceration, it would likely be house arrest, which would enable the former president to continue his campaign via video, via Zoom, you know, that kind of thing. I don't think there's going to be any scenario in which there'll be incarceration, even house arrest, you know, for the interim period. So I think the judge will be fair, as he's been fair to the former president throughout this trial.
We haven't got too long before the election. Will they decide on sentencing before that?
He may decide on sentencing, but the court may also suspend it pending appeal. And my guess is, you know, in light of the fairness, in light of the concerns that Judge Merchan expressed previously in the context of the gag order and the violations of the gag order, you recall that Judge Merchan actually said to the president and former president and his counsel directly, said, the last thing I want to do is to jail your client. So I would expect that the actual punishment be kept on hold pending appeal. But the impact of 34 felony convictions, I believe, will be seismic.
So if you're just joining us, Donald Trump has been found guilty of those 34 felony charges, is now labelled a convicted felon. Just a historic moment. Benjamin, just before we let you go really quickly, this could all mean, though, if Donald Trump becomes president, he could pardon himself.
No, actually, he can't. It's a fair question. He could pardon himself if this were a federal crime. We have a federalist system here in the United States by which states and the federal government are separate sovereigns. So he cannot, as a matter of law, pardon himself either as to this conviction or if he were to be convicted in the Georgia case. The two federal prosecutions, you're absolutely right. He could essentially, if he were reelected president, have his attorney general basically stop the prosecutions altogether.
Wow.
Benjamin, we have seen protests and the mood heighten in America while this has been going on. What do you think this will do for the general mood in America?
I think it's going to be tamped down. I think the former president has expressed disappointment at the lack of crowds who attended this trial. In fact, one day of court, there was only one Trump supporter outside. I think that's what prompted the rush of his insisting that some of his supporters on the Hill come attend the hearing. I think there's been a somewhat of a sobering impact in the U.S. after all the convictions of the 1-6 rioters. I think there have been approximately 1,000 people who have been sentenced to prison. So I don't think there are a lot of people who are willing to go to jail for the former president.
It was quite remarkable to hear those cheers from those anti-Donald Trump protesters out the front of that courthouse today when that verdict was brought forward. U.S. lawyer Benjamin Chu, thank you for your time.
Thank you so much for having me.